There's people trying to watch the game, so we good.
Test, 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 test. Test, 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 test.
Check, 1, 2. Check, check.
Okay, so now let me...
Testing, 1, 2, test.
Okay. No.
Okay.
You were just on the text that I had for everybody else.
All right, so we got some volume now?
I think so. I think we should be good.
Carl, if you're listening, text me. Let me know if you can hear
our show
or anybody.
Somebody. Trial and error, folks. Trial and error.
Carl or Rochelle, if you can hear us, let us know if you can hear us all right. Or if you still get a lot of background noise or...
Yeah, if we come in loud and clear.
The O2. What kind of delay do we have here? Not much, is it?
I'm not sure. See, our signal is weak.
Gotcha.
So I'm thinking we should. You were saying it's power on that side, but it's power right here, too. So do you put it on this side, the camera?
I don't think it matters which side you put it on. As long as we got what we need, you're going to need internet access. So,
right. Because you can either go to that switch in the office or the switch to what you call them.
Testing 1, 2, testing 1, 2, 3, testing 1, 2, 3, check, check, check.
Let us know, people.
Somebody, if you hear us, let us know. We'll get back to our broadcast. Mm-hmm. Testing, 1, 2, check. All right, I think we got some volume now. All right, so first half, Wildcats trail 29-16, 4 minutes to go here at halftime. During that first half, we were messing around with things, trying to get things figured out as this is all new to us. So we're still going to be experimenting through the night to make sure this may work, and we'll go from there. What do you need, bud? Anyway, Wildcats trail 29-16, around the difference in the first half. The Wildcats came out hot in the first quarter. In the second half, I only had them down for 2 points, 3 points in the second quarter.
Why? I mean, from what I can see, without trying to, they got off to a quick start, but the Mexico kids just lit on fire.
Yep, Wildcats came out hot. Mexico did too in the second quarter. So 29-16, we go scoring here. What I got is I got Seth Walton for two, Adrian Combs with a three-pointer, Wyatt March with a two-pointer, Kobe Ellis with two free throws and a field goal for four, and Cameron Knapp with 4 points in the first half. Again, only two, I believe, if I was counting that correctly, only two in the second quarter. So it looked like to me, just basically as we were looking down and messing with stuff and trying to watch the game on top of it, it looked to me as the full court press or the 1-2-2 half court zone trap that they always do. They've been doing that forever, even when I was coaching them. Looked like that started to impact the Wildcats a little bit there in the second quarter. All right.
So you get any feedback on how we sound? Or
yeah, I think Rochelle says she can hear us all right.
Yeah, if you're tuning in, folks, give us as much feedback as possible so we can try to get, you know, if it's lagging or anything, just let us know.
We're going to keep it rolling so we don't shut it off and have to restart it. Every time we reboot it, we got to send out a different link. So,
exactly.
We'll keep it rolling. 2:25 to go at halftime. Wildcats trail 29-16. Again, tale of two quarters. First quarter, Wildcats came out hot and on fire and fizzled out pretty quick as the Mexico press started to kick in. And the, not only the press, but the transition from Mexico as they got the rebound and took off down the floor. They started hitting some shots and started to pull away a little bit in the second half. Coach Graves burned two timeouts. Minute 56 to go. Ron should have it on the clock there for you so you can see what's going on. Again, the Mexico boys will play, or excuse me, the eighth grade boys will play after this game. Ron and I are just trying to figure out a way for us to be able to sit around at home and watch since so many restrictions, not just up tonight, and their restrictions for home games are zero fans.
Oh, wow.
So, and one other feature that hopefully we have up and running here in the next couple weeks. In the gym, and it will stream and show you scoreboard, hopefully, of every contest in any event we have here in the high school gym moving forward. The goal is to get that going here for too long, and we're not going to be able to broadcast every game, obviously, but hopefully with that huddle focus camera, we'll be able to shoot some video footage, and you'll have a scoreboard here. Now, you won't have live broadcast, but you'll have a video. And you'll also have a scoreboard in the bottom corner so you can keep track of the time and the score and what's going on. And several schools in the area purchased these cameras with the restrictions that are taking place. And I've watched and looked at it in across the timeline. And Chase guarded the ball up front. Good move there by number 22, a one-foot shot. And he missed his rebound by Seth Walton. He takes it up to court. Crosses the timeline to Adrian Combs to the right corner. Passes down to the right wing to Seth. Back out to the top to Adrian. Cross court to Chase. Looks at a three. Doesn't take it. And I think he walked there. He lost the ball. It's a tough call. Lost the ball. It's hard to travel when you don't have possession. He was trying to get the ball back. And it looked kind of funny, so it makes sense there. Mexico down, bringing the ball back across half court. Wildcats kind of sinking back, trying to catch up to the defense. Number 22 pulls up from way downtown. Misses off Wildcat into the Mexico hands. He takes a shot and misses. Cameron Knapp with the rebound and looking for a guard, and it's deflected right back to Mexico on the left wing out to the top. the key. He's looking to take another deep shot, dribbles in, reverse, drops it down to the post, kicks it back out to the three-point line, down a couple dribbles, pulls up from the free throw line, misses, air ball, rebound again by Mexico, kicks it back to the top of the key, pulls it out, tries to reset, kicks it to the left, wide open for three, no good, off a couple wild kicks, no good, Walton with the rebound. Got to slow down here, Ron. It's getting kind of chaotic.
Yeah. I mean, they're hoisting shots up. And
makes the score 29-18.
With them shooting up shots, you guys have to concentrate on rebounding.
Chase has got three fouls. Chase Kitson's got three fouls, so he's got to be careful what he's doing. He's reaching. That's on the floor, two shot. They're going to give it to him, and then he nails it. It's a two ball. He was on the line. They called it right when he let it go. So Wildcats get the ball out, trying, and back the other way we go. Mexico in transition, moving down the floor fast. Walton tries to take a charge. He gets it. Good call. Good.
It's probably the best thing for you to look to draw a charge.
Good play by Seth. Wildcats going to inbound. Chase Quaytham with the ball, passes it in to Adrian Combs to the corner. Kicks it back to the middle to Chase. He tries to take a few dribbles, gets it to the middle of the floor to Noah Beck. Back, got to get it across. Running out of time here. And
yeah, bad pass. Wasn't ready for that one.
Wildcats trail 31-18, 3:22 to go here in the third quarter. Seventh grade Montgomery County basketball, Wildcats versus Mexico. Mexico across the timeline. They're taking their time now, starting to slow down. He's got the ball at the top of the key, trying to get to the basket. He gets in, fires up a shot off the back iron. No good. Rebound, Adrian Combs. Gets the ball across half court in not a transition mode, but slower mode. Ball's tipped and knocked away. Mexico back in transition off his hands, out of bounds. Montgomery County ball, 31-18.
You just got to be careful with those passes, Adam. They're not setting their feet. They're trying to pass the ball too quickly.
Jump ball. Ron says the video is pausing and cutting out. Not sure if it's on our end or mine. I've got that for two different people.
Okay. Our end. Well, we've got a wireless signal.
Three people.
I'm going to have to call it tonight because
it's a wireless, not very. What's the deal with?
Well, we only got to get a better signal.
Okay.
See, it's saying your connection is unstable.
Yep. It looks like if you're able to hear us, it looks like our signal here in the gym where we're sitting is weak. We'll try to figure something out, see if we can't get that going. May move to the state and try something for the high school gym to get closer to the access point. We'll go ahead and keep on going here while we can. Wildcats trail 31-18. Combs fires a three, in and out. Rebound, Chase Quaytham back up. Looks like it was tipped and rebounded by Mexico. They're going to push the ball. Kicks it down the court to number 11. Wide open putback, and it's good. 33-18. Mexico leads. Inbounds to Adrian Combs. Back to the middle to Noah Beck. Cross the timeline to Seth Walton. Cross the court again to Adrian. He tries to force pass inside. It's deflected, stolen by Mexico. Down two-on-one transition. Up and good. 35-18. Mexico, 1:42 to go, third quarter. Inbound, stolen, thrown off of the Wildcats. Looks, missed the call there. Wildcats score on the other end, cut the lead to 20-15. Bulldogs, 106 to go here in the third quarter. Mexico taking their time, tries to feed it down low, overshoots him out of bounds. Wildcats ball to Adrian Combs, dribbles across, under a minute to go here in the third quarter as the Wildcats need to get hot. Turnovers have been kind of, there's another one. The turnovers have kind of kicked us in the butt a little bit. Ball's deflected, picked up by Mexico. They take off running down the floor. Bad pass by them, stolen by Adrian Combs, trying to go the other way. gets the ball across the line to Noah back on the left wing, kicks it in the Chase at the top of the key, and deflected again. That time Chase on the floor gets it. Good there. Passes it from the floor to number 12 for Montgomery County. Mac Ferrari goes in and gets fouled for the free throw attempt. Ferrari to line shooting two. First one is up, and he knocks it down. Makes the score 36-21. Second free throw on the way, 29.5 to go here in the third quarter, 36-21, Wildcats trail. The difference in the game has been transition and turnovers. Ferrari knocks down the second one. Makes the score 36-22 in favor of the Bulldogs. Nobody guarding the ball. He fires it up from way downtown. Misses, rebounded, put back up, and scores.
You definitely got to get on those rebounds. They're hoisting. Mexico's hoisting up a lot of shots. So you got to know you got to start concentrating on getting rebounds.
Camera. All right. It's all trial and error for us. A lot different than Friday Night Football and what we're doing with that.
Sure.
So we're trying to figure it out, do this on our own. So maybe we can do this in the future. So excuse
Just
us.
Bear with this.
Yeah, excuse us as we try to figure this out on the way. Again, on Fridays, we have everything taking place back at the station. All we're doing is talking and watching football. So we're trying to do it all here from the bleachers at Montgomery County. Wildcat Trail 38-22. To start the fourth. So pressure and turnovers, I think, has been the difference in the game. That 1-2-2 trap has been kept us from our transition game, I should say. Let's go ahead and we'll take a 1 minute break. Excuse me, a 30 second break. We'll be right back.
So one thing I can do is when they run the camera, run plug in for a wire connection.
Mexico ball inbound. They lead 38-22. Start the fourth quarter here. Drive to the basket. No call. Up, rebounded Walton. Kicks it up court. Takes it down the left side and is in for two. Makes the score 38-24. Good take there.
Yeah, a lot more of that. But I think with, like I said, with the way Mexico's shooting, they really need to concentrate on getting the rebound.
Yep. I agree. They've been
they're not shooting at a very high percentage. So. A lot of rebounds to be had.
38-24, 5:22 to go here in the fourth quarter. Mexico taking their time, pick and roll, high pick and roll down the left. It's good. Seems like he's scoring about every other trip down the court. Number 10. Mexico got to the top of the key. Adrian picks his dribble up, finds Noah Beck, kicks it baseline, pulls up, kicks it back out to the left wing. Excuse me, right wing. Adrian's going to take it all the way to the basket and misses the layup. Rebound, transition, there they go, down the other way, layup, oh, that's a travel. He lost control on the way up and can't do that.
We caught a break on that one. These kids, these Mexico kids, they're getting out quick, making crisp passes, and kind of hard to keep up.
Wildcats bring the ball down, left wing, Combs picks up his dribble, looking for somebody to help him out, still looking, and Chase comes, gets the ball. Tosses over to the right wing to Noah Beck. He's looking down low. Nothing there. Finds Chase at the high post. Turn. Good pass. Chase up and good. And a foul. And a foul. Good job there. Turn and look. And that's how you got to beat that zone. You got to catch the ball to the high post and back the basket. Turn and look.
Exactly. And somebody needs to dive towards the basket. That way you're giving them an outlet.
Yep. He catches the high post. Everybody comes flying up. Baseline's wide open. Bucket's good, and 40-26, Wildcats trail, 4:22 to go here in the fourth quarter. Noah back at the line, shooting one. Shot is up, and it's good. Makes the score 40-27, so
Not over yet. Get on a little roll here. Mexico not taking their time. They're still trying to get down the court and make something happen. They do have it at the top of the key. Kicks it to the right side, back to the top of the key. He penetrates, pulls up. Yeah. Nice pass down low with buckets. Good. 3:57 to go, fourth quarter. Wildcats have to pick it up and get it going here, especially on the defense side of the ball. They dribble the ball across half court. Passes to Quaytham on the right wing, looking down to Knapp. Found him on the wing. Knapp up and good. 49-22. Good pass and good shot there by Cameron. Mexico down the court here. Dribbles, penetrates to the baseline. Fires up a three this time. No good. Oh, pushing the back. No call. Chase Quaytham with the rebound. Long rebound. He tries to dribble down the court. Ball nearly stolen. He's kind of in a bad situation there now. The coach may have to call timeout. Did he get it to him? Nope. They didn't get it to him. They gave him a jump ball instead.
Ball stays with the Wildcats.
Yep. Ball stays with Montgomery County. Noah Beck's going to take it out. And Coach Graves over there hauling for timeout. Tough situation there. Didn't get it. 42-29 here. 3:21 to go here in the fourth quarter. Montgomery County trails. Ball's inbounded to Adrian Combs. Dribbles across the timeline. Dribbles to the left wing. Back to the top of the key to Noah Beck. Basically, tries to turn. Loses the ball. Cameron gets it. Mexico defense has been pretty good. They're back on the ground. Ball's all over the place. Mexico picks it up this time. They're taking off down the other way. Kicks it out to the left wing. Shot is up. Short. Rebounded Ellis. Kicks it out to the Cameron on the wing. Ball out of bounds. Passes. Off of Montgomery County. Silly pass there. And just couldn't get the ball in position before he ran out of bounds.
And when you see your kids having difficulty with that, you know, just make them slow down, stop, make passes. And more than the passer is who he's passing it to, need to help also.
Mexico still firing it up there, 2:32 to go, 42-29, Wildcats trail. It's kind of an ill-advised shot there for the Bulldogs. He fires up a long-range three up with no reason to fire it up there. He fires it up anyway. Noah Beck's got the ball at the top of the key, looking for some help. Dribble penetration, pulls it back out, kicks it to the top of the key to Cameron. Ball's knocked away. No call there. Can't advance it. Can't advance it. Good call. He's lost the ball on his own, and you can pick it up and stop, but you can't keep on going. So good call there by the official. Travel call. 2:03-2:29. Ball inbounded. Get to Combs. Across midcourt. Looking at the high post, finds Cameron at the free throw line, turns and looks. Cameron kicks it out to the baseline to Seth Walton, back out top to the right wing to Cone, back to the top of the key to Ellis. Looking down low again, dribbles to the right side, all the way to the basket, up, and just misses, comes in for the rebound. Mexico gets it. They're still going 100 miles an hour down the sideline in transition. They pull it back, fire up a shot, no good, rebounded Walton, and foul there on Mexico. This is so much different than a football game.
Yeah.
I'm just so comfortable
doing
constant.
Yeah, it's constant action.
It's just so much different. All right. After the foul, inbounds to Combs. Cross half court. Minute 29 to go left in the game. Wildcats trail 42-29. And we got to get something going here quick. Looking for a high screen. Cameron gets it, passes to the left wing to Noah Beck, back to the top of the key to Cameron Knapp. Looking down low, nothing there. Cameron tries to drive, gets a hand. We got a 3-second call on the Wildcats. So a minute 12 to go. Mexico's going to take over.
Yes, minute 12. And I guarantee you Mexico's not looking to run the clock down.
No, they're going to fire it up here as soon as they get a chance. He is kind of patient right now, but defense comes out on him. Spins off the high post. Good defense there by Adrian. Still good defense. He gets around, kicks to the corner. Here comes the three ball, fires it up. No good on the back. Yep, good call. Good call there on number 22. Pushing the back. That's his fourth, team sixth. 49.5 to go here in the fourth quarter. Wildcats cross half court. Again, clock is ticking. Got to get a shot up quick. Combs to Ellis. Almost stolen. Is stolen. Knocked down and pushed by Colby. New Mexico ball. It's only 13 foul for Montgomery, so not going to the line yet. 42-29. Ron, I think most of our points came in the first quarter and the third quarter. Not much happened in the second and the fourth. Now Mexico's taking their time. Ball across. 30 seconds to go here. Noah Beck guarding the ball handler. He takes it to the left, kicks it back out to the top as they reset, let clock run off. Adrian guarding him this time, trying to keep him close enough to get a count. He dribbles down the lane, kicks it to the corner, fires it up. No good. Rebound. 6-5-4. And shot goes up. No good. That's the game. 42-29. Wildcats fall to the Bulldogs here in game number three, I believe, on the season. So is our signal still kind of?
Yeah, it's going to be because okay. That's the only.
Will it help if we go to the stage?
Oh, it'll definitely help being close.
Where Scott's at and try to get a stronger signal. At least, I mean, there's been several radio stations that have broadcasted from that vantage point during the tournament over the years.
Sure, so have.
We'll see if we can give it a shot and try to get a little better quality here to start the.
And I don't have to move the camera much.
Right, yeah, just let it go. That's right. All right, we're gonna give that a shot.
So we're gonna game is about 15 send out another time. Link because we're gonna have to end this stream and move everything to the stage. So bear with us. Like I said, this is trial and error. We're gonna try to do some more games this season. Like Adam mentioned, we're gonna get that one camera. That's there won't be any commentary at least, but you can at least watch the games in the comfort of your own home.
Yep. All right. We're going to shut her down, try to move to the stage. We'll hopefully be back with an eighth grade game here before too long. Take care.
Aaron, you want to help us carry stuff?